I'm Carson Daly. Welcome back to our special presentation of MTV Live, the Marilyn Manson edition, which originally aired 1 month ago today, when it, too, was Friday the 13th. You just saw something cool between Marilyn and some of his fans, which you don't get to see that often, them having a chance in such an intimate atmosphere to ask him some questions, and really about his music and his personal life. Now you're about to see Marilyn talk about the release of his new home video, and also put to rest some of these rumors that you might have heard. So here's a chance to figure out what's fact and what's fiction about Marilyn Manson. I wasn't really trying. When you look at your fans like at a show, like, do you ever just go, wow, like, look what I've started, and they're missing the message and just here to, like, rebel against something that may not have anything to do with what you're talking about?
No, I think they're being creative. I think it's pretty good. I think it's healthy.
Right.
For them to just express themselves, you know, in this form gives them the ability to, so.
Right. Let's talk about when you're at the shows and the controversy. Do you think it's a necessity to have the people outside protesting as well as the people inside enjoying?
I don't think, I mean, we didn't used to have it before Antichrist Superstar so much, but I'd probably be bored without it now, so I look forward to more of it to come in the future.
And you did a little videotaping. Tell us about the home video, Dead to the World.
The home video was filmed by a lot of my friends, actually. It's because I like having people that I know around, and I felt like I could trust them to capture what I was looking for. So, you know, they take the shows, and there was a lot of stuff, unfortunately, that wasn't allowed to be in there.
Was this your idea of wanting to show people, like, almost exactly what goes on, like a behind-the-scenes sort of, this is what we see sort of video?
I guess, you know, it's hard for me to be objective about it because I'm kind of oblivious to everything
right.
That's around me, so... It was kind of the first time for me to see it, so
yeah.
It's as exciting to me as it is to anybody else, I guess, because I've never seen it.
All right, well, let's have a look at it. You can see it for the first time. Here we go. Dead in the World. Did someone design like prosthetic devices for you? Because I know you're sort of into that. All the toys.
No, I ended up having to make a lot of it myself, you know, because things like that don't really exist except in someone's imagination. So I just explained to whoever was making it what I wanted.
This is what I envisioned, make me on like stilts.
Well, whenever I heard that song, I always kind of envisioned myself as this kind of monster that my grandfather was as a child. So
right.
Bigger than life.
What's the one thing that you've ever read about yourself that you just went like, all right, that's it. I've heard it all now. This is complete BS. Like, this is so not true. It's actually pissing me off.
Just about everything. recently they said I got Uma Thurman pregnant. I've never even met her. I guess I get blamed for everything.
Are you upset about that?
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure that I saw Twiggy doing that.
Right. Don't blame me. Twiggy's mishap. All right, well, we've been talking about being on the show, and we've received thousands of emails, and we've sort of gathered all the ones that were sort of related to common rumors about you. Is it true Marilyn and Fiona Apple are married? Sort of
that
rundown.
Is not true. I actually went on one sort of date with her.
How'd that go?
I think that I scared her.
Right.
We went to the Howard Stern party. No, I have a girlfriend, but it's not Fiona Apple. So.
Right.
It's Rose McGowan.
Rose, where is
you interviewed her?
Where is she? She's supposed to be here.
She's scared too.
Is she? All right. Yeah.
Oh, you? Not just me.
No, we had a cool talk. We just wrapped out.
She told me you were.
No. No, she's lying, and you know it. She did not say that.
No, she
didn't. Because I was dancing like all around the Marilyn Manson thing with Rose when she was here. I was just like, Rose, are you happy? I don't care. I don't want to know the nightmare. She's like, yeah, I'm with Marilyn. He makes me very happy. He likes my dogs. He's not having sex with them. That's all I needed to hear. This is actually when I worked at K-Rock in L.A. Believe it or not, I got this a lot. Is it true that you played the son of TV's Mr. Belvedere? Where did this start from?
You know, I've never even seen that show. It started with Wonder Years. They used to say I was on that. And then they said the rumor about me removing my rib so I could perform oral sex on myself.
Well, there goes email number four. That's what that was.
See, it stands to reason if I could perform oral sex on myself, then I wouldn't be on the Wonder Years chasing Winnie Cooper.
Very good answer.
Kind of cancel each other. That would be at home.
Right. And actually, in the book, it does explain how that whole rumor came about. What happened that night on stage? There was two of you dressed alike when you...
Oh, right. I don't think we can talk about that.
No, we can't, but it's in the book.
It's in the book. Read the book.
Did you really have your earlobes done?
I cut off my earlobes once at some point in my life.
Now, does all this, like, self-mutilation, people don't understand it? Explain what it feels like to you and sort of why you do it.
I don't really think I have an explanation for it. I don't think it's something that... I'm proud of or can explain. It's just something that, you know, it's different points in my life, different ways I was feeling. Right. And now it becomes like, I guess, a roadmap of my past if I have any sort of scars, whether they're emotional or not, you know.
Wear them like badges. We're gonna take a phone call. Hello?
Hello?
Hi, what's your name?
Beth.
Hi, Beth, where are you calling from?
New Jersey.
New Jersey, do you have a question for Marilyn Manson?
Yes. How many hours of sleep do you get a night, and what do you dream about?
Good question.
It depends on if I'm with Twiggy or not.
All right, let's go with Twiggy.
With Twiggy, I'm going to say 0 to
negative
one. To 1 hour. Last night I dreamed, I'm trying to think what I dreamed about. Well, the other night I dreamed that my father had cut his chest open. He was showing me his insides.
Really?
But I think it was because he had just told me that he was going to the hospital to be checked for some back problems. So I think usually my dreams kind of relate to whatever I'm thinking about when I go to bed.
And dreams were responsible for a lot of the lyrics in Antichrist Superstar, right?
Absolutely. I mean, they continue to be an influence. Right. The next record is really based off of a dream about me kind of going off into space and coming back in the world being a totally different place.
Wow.
So I continue to kind of just get really involved into what happens when you're asleep just as much as when you're awake.
Right. All right, let's take another call. Hello?
Hi.
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 This is Erica. I have a fast story for you right before I ask you my question. I created an 8-foot by 6-foot painting of you last year as a school project, but because so many were against it, because they had preconceived notions about you, but because of your influence on me, which is very positive, you gave me the strength and inspiration to complete it, even though many were against it, and I would like to thank you for that, and I also would like to give it to you as a gift, but I have to go to my question now. Do you ever get creatively frustrated? If so, how do you handle it?
I think I always get creatively frustrated. That's part of anybody's process of making things. If you were happy doing what you do all the time, I don't think anything great would come out of it.
Right.
And do you think it's possible that people didn't like the painting just because they thought I was ugly?
No, they just didn't like what you were about. They thought I was like too involved with it.
They thought you were Picasso, and
it was the alleged sexual relationship with Dave Navarro, I think, they're probably...
Very good. Which we're going to get through in just a couple of minutes. Thank you for your call. We'll come right back with more of Marilyn Manson on MTV Live. Stick around, please.
Some serious horror stories, and my mother is serious. He would tell me stories about the boogeyman, so I would be scared to go to bed. One night I was awesome and running in my sleep. I wake up and I run to my mother. I tell my mother, Mommy, I want to kill this boogeyman. My mother hold me. And here what my mother tells me, Junior, even the ugliest monster need love. And from that time on, when I'm watching MTV and I see Marilyn Manson, I want that woman. I want to give that woman the love she deserves, the nurturing, the caring. Bring that woman to Patrick Thomas. Bring she to Patrick Thomas.